A few weeks ago, we had our first shoot with Blackmagic Pocket 6K using a green screen. Yay! Unfortunately, what we came to see in post is that we underexposed a few of the scenes. And this is one of those. Because of this, we decided to run some tests to determine what the best exposure would be.
Who's we? You decided. We.
I don't we, it's a whole team, man. It's a whole team of people.
It's just you.
Yeah, I decided to run some tests, but you guys were in it, I guess. So I decided to run some tests to see what the perfect exposure would be at each ISO. Before we dive into the tests, I want to draw attention to a few things. The first one is the dynamic range chart for the Blackmagic 6K, which is available on their website.
It tells you how many stops you can recover from overexposure and how many stops from underexposure at each ISO. However, it doesn't tell you how noisy the image is gonna be.
And then the second thing is false colors. I found this chart that was made for the Blackmagic 4K, but it seems to do the trick for the 6K as well. And then the second chart that you see is the one that you can have for your Atomos and probably other monitors as well. And the third thing is called LUT Calc, and it's a really good application that you can download for a very small price.
You can get an f-stop to IRE equivalent, which is very, very useful. For the exposure correction, I used a number of tools from DaVinci, including the ISO tool. What I found interesting here is that I was half expecting that the noise profile of the image would change if I changed the ISO from the camera raw menu, but it doesn't. So when you're shooting, don't forget about the ISO brackets that you can also change from the camera raw. One thing that I found very useful when I had overexposed scenes was the highlight recovery button. So I hooked up the Blackmagic to an Atomos Ninja 5 and I set the Atomos to false color, so this is what you're getting in the left hand side corner. For ISO 100, we can go as low as more than 3 stops underexposed and we have low noise. ISO 200, we see virtually no noise from about negative 2.5 f-stop. For ISO 400, in the underexposed scenes, if we push it, so we have maybe a little bit of noise, we can recover kind of as much as from what we could recover in ISO 200. In the overexposed section, we can recover everything that's below the white clipping, so the red zone. I would say that if you look really closely, the stuff that is in the yellow area have maybe a little bit of a loss in the information in color, so I see it as maybe a little bit less saturated. So 800. In the underexposed areas by the same amount, which were virtually noiseless for ISO 100 and 200. And in 400, we started seeing some noise. Now they're super noisy. I'd say that the first noiseless overall exposure for this scene is where the face is at about 2.5 stops overexposed. But just to be safe that I'd get no noise in the black areas of the clothes, I'd expose at about IRE 70. So about maybe an extra half of an f-stop overexposed. So her face would be around 3 stops overexposed. For ISO 1600, if you don't have the face at around 2.5 stops overexposed, you're gonna get noise. All that's not in the green or almost in the green area or higher is noisy. So basically everything that's more underexposed than 1 stop is gonna be noisy. For ISO 30-200, all that's not exposed at exactly the correct exposure or higher than that has a bit of noise. Unfortunately here, the exposure for the face goes around the 80% range to get rid of all the noise in the shadows completely. So yeah, maybe ISO 30-200 is not a great ISO to use if you're using a high contrast scene or a dark scene. For ISO 6400, the noise pattern and the exposure levels are roughly the same as ISO 30-200. So the first conclusion that I have is that if you shoot under ISO 400, then you're okay to underexpose a lot, so you don't really need to worry about exposure. If you're shooting between ISO 400 and 800, you have to make sure that you don't have areas in the image that are underexposed by more than 1.5 f-stops. If you shoot commercials and you want super crisp image, I wouldn't push the ISO further than 1600. You're okay to overexpose up to 80%, so just under the white clipping point, which is to say that the IRE value should be about 77, and it's about 3.5 f-stops in overexposure. If you were to keep one rule out of everything, it would be to have your skin overexposed by about 2.5 f-stops, which is to say 70% or 65 IRE value.
Thank you, Truck.
Thank you, Truck. My first experience being in front of the camera, it sucks and it takes a very long time. Okay, thank you for listening or watching. Thank you for watching this video. If you like, subscribe. If you want footage from these tests, let me know. If you know why the ISO noise profile doesn't change when you change the ISO in the camera raw, let me know. If I find out at some point, I'm probably gonna make another really nerdy video about it. Okay. This is really awful. I don't think I'm gonna be standing in front of the camera from now on. Have a good day.
We're gonna let the fatso go.
Yeah, exactly. Bye. Hold on. No. My teeth sabotaged me on.